The Lord has had me in a season of talking to people who have issues with homosexuality. Excuse me. A whole group of them. All at the same time, and God always works in patterns. The Lord had me dealing with like one problem all over the place kind of at the same time, and it goes in seasons, and the Lord is teaching me. You know, I've had several viewers that's been watching me for a long time who have homosexual tendencies. There's a difference between living in homosexuality, just like people have a desire there's a former alcoholic. They have a desire to be drunk, but they're not doing it. There's people who have homosexual tendencies. They desire to practice homosexuality, but they don't. There's even one brother I'm asking you to pray for him. His name is Leo. He's publicly commented on my videos way back, even for 2 or 3 years. Brother Leo, I ask you to pray for him. He has AIDS, and he's a recovering former homosexual practicer, and he's repented of that. He still, of course, still has those desires, but he's given his life to Christ. Brother Leo, I ask you to pray for him. There's another brother. His first initial is A. He has homosexual tendencies. And he has trouble with those thoughts attacking him. I ask you to pray. First initial A. Pray for this brother. And I made that video about Bruce Jenner too. There's a young person who contacted me who was actually born with kind of a medical condition. There's people with medical conditions where it's questionable whether they're male or female. And then their parents try to assign them one way or the other. And I've seen something years ago on 48 Hours or whatever, one of those shows way back 10, 20 years ago where they were talking about that. And the parents assigned this child, to be a boy, a girl, but this child was really a boy and vice versa. You see these situations. This is not the same as what Bruce Jenner's doing. And so I have a viewer who's kind of in that situation, that's could have kind of went either way, but it's what's in your mind. So I ask you to pray for this person, because the person has a mind to be one, but the family had tried to get them to identify with the other gender. So there are people that have birth defects also that we need to account for. Of course, I already knew that. I just didn't mention it in the video I made about Bruce Jenner. I want to mention it now. So I ask you to pray for those people, that God would give them peace. There are people that are born with these, like a birth defect and all that. And it's, our sexuality is a huge part of our identity as a person, to be a man or a woman. So I ask you to pray for them. And I will even say this, we should pray for all homosexuals, of course. God loves everybody. God wants everybody to be born again. God wants everybody to go to heaven. God doesn't want any to perish, but all to come to repentance, the Bible says. God is not, because the Bible's talking about God, why we haven't had the rapture yet. And God says, and the Bible says, God is not, slack to make the rapture later. He just is delaying it because he wants none to perish but all to come to repentance. So brothers and sisters, I ask you to pray in agreement with me for the three people I talked about. I won't give an initial or anything on the third person. I guess I could, an initial, C. I ask you to pray for this sister, initial C, Brother A, and then the other brother who has AIDS, Leo, who's publicly commented about this on my videos. Brother Leo. And I ask you to pray for them and all the other people, even people who are even like Bruce Jenner and all this. I pray that they get delivered, that they would have a peace, that they would have a deliverance from God, and that they would have peace, and they would be settled in their identity as a human in Christ. So let's pray for their salvation and deliverance. Now, these three people that I asked you to pray for are saved, and they're struggling with this, and they need help from the Holy Spirit to overcome this temptation. It's like people with alcohol, whatever it is, and their identity. And then, like I said, we pray for all homosexuals, that they will be delivered, they'll be saved, the people who are transgender and all this. Now, I just want you to think about this. Can you imagine the mental torment that someone who is trying to be, like Bruce Jenner, people like this, what is the mental torment they're going through? It's evil. It's horrible. So we need to pray for them. We pray for them to be delivered, that they will have their peace and joy in Christ. So I ask you guys to pray for them, and I'm not, The reason why I mention about homosexuality is because the church is saying it's not a sin. Now, that's the problem. When the church says that practicing fornication, for one thing, marriage is between a man and a woman no matter what anybody says. So it's already a sin to have sex with somebody you're not married to. And then homosexual sex is a whole other sin. You know, and all those things that could be involved in that, you know, with anything like these things. All of that stuff that you people get into. Even more perversions than that, whatever kind of sick, perverted things that people do on beyond that. Way on and on and on and on what people do. And all of these people, God wishes none of them to perish, but all to come to repentance. God's still on the throne. He still has a mission for His church. And the great commission that we have is to go and to make disciples of the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Ghost. And these signs shall follow those that believe. In My name they'll cast out demons. They lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. They will speak with new tongues. Talking about Mark chapter 16. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I gave the message that the Lord gave me to give. And I pray that you get free of religiosity. Don't take your advice from all these people who are not preachers, who are not ordained ministers on YouTube. That's what I'm asking you to do. So much false advice and misinformation on YouTube. Every day I have somebody messaging me, telling me, you know, there's so much misinformation on YouTube. People trying to stand in the place of a preacher and they're not. I pray for all those people because we have to give a special account. There's a special account to be given when we're trying to teach the Word of God. God bless you guys. I love you guys. I ask you to pray as we're getting ready to go back to the States next week. Pray for Joshua's ministry as we expand the feeding programs. Now, did I mention this? No, I didn't. I made a video that I'm not loading, so I'll mention it here. Those of you who are still watching, we're going to go ahead and put a couple of kids, two children in the fourth orphanage. You know, we don't have to build a building right now. They already have a house. The one I asked you to pray for, Brother James, or James, the husband. The wife is a Christian. The husband is James, and he's been drinking. He's a drinker for years and years and years, even though he's a nice guy. But anyway, you know, he's agreed that he's going to stop drinking. And so he's, you know, the whole thing, too, about Joshua's ministries is a process for people to get saved. This is a process in the life of people. So the Lord will use this whole thing for James to get saved. So he's already agreed that he wants to do that. So we're going to go ahead, because I'm getting ready to leave. We're going to go ahead and put two children with them under the supervision of the person in charge when I leave. That's the house mom of orphanage number one. My first translator when I came to the Philippines and started preaching since 2005. So 10 years now. I've known the house mom and dad of orphanage number one, Pastora Rowana. It's her first name, Rowana. And she will be in charge while I'm gone, and she will oversee that the husband is going to stop drinking and all that. And so that'll be the fourth orphanage, brothers and sisters. We're going to put two children with them and see how it goes. So I ask you to pray about that for James to stop drinking. I guess he's becoming a brother. Let's put it that way. It's a process for him. And his wife is already a Christian. I will make a video with them. I try to get down there and see them both. I saw the wife, not the husband this time. Just talked to him, but didn't see him in person. Get this worked out, brothers and sisters. In orphanage number three, I ask you to pray. I'm going to have two or three kids there. Two kids at orphanage number four. So, of course, I need prayers for all this. And the feeding programs, we went from 800 to 1,000 kids. I just made the video as the churches where we're doing the feedings are exploding in attendance. Like I said, I just gave them the money to buy 50 chairs. We need to buy more. We really, you know, I believe the Lord wants us to expand these churches. There's poor people there who live in a shack. They're going to send me pictures of a new area we're doing a feeding, and the people live in shacks that are so raggedy and so broken. It's just Filipinos say that it's unfit to live in. Now, that's bad because there's lots of Filipinos who live in shacks, and these Filipinos, some of them who live in shacks, who help with the feedings, are telling me these houses are unfit. They can't even call it a house. They're at one of the places, the dump site we've been doing feeding at for the last few months. Anyway, we even want to help them to build some new houses. Now, the churches themselves are trying to donate, but they don't have a lot of money. People are really poor people. They're donating what they can, so they donate like 25 cents, you know. And that's their tithe. You know, but we, brothers and sisters, can do this. We can do that. We need to even expand some of these churches. Lots of new projects. Of course, I want to do all that the Lord would let us do, all that our budget would let us do, as we expand to more and more feedings. more and more orphanages, more and more orphans that need us, and all those things, Lord, to continue to grow for the Lord. So I ask you guys to please pray for all these things, because, you know, like I said, even though I just made this video preaching as the Lord led me, the problem with most people, they're armchair quarterbacks. They're theoretical Christians. I mean, like I say, I always laugh when people try to debate doctrine with me, like about a pre-tribulation rapture or whatever. They're, you know, people are living in their plush houses, and then, you know, around the world, not only the Philippines, but there's people that don't even have anything to eat. You know, and where's the church? That's another message. I mentioned that in a video the other day. You know, where's the church? We're supposed to be like that song by, I challenge you to go listen to the song. I need to make a video. You know, Casting Crowns. If we are the body, why aren't our hands doing? Why aren't our feet going? If we're the body, why are we not moving and doing the will of God, making disciples of the nations? And making disciples is all those things. There's people that need food. You go to a rich country, the people don't need food, but they need to hear the gospel. They need to see signs and wonders, all those things. In a poor country, sometimes they need to see food and signs and wonders, and then hear the word, all those things. You know, Paul said, I become all things to all people that I might win some to Christ. You know, so I would just say you should feel blessed that you know me, because, you know, I don't hardly know any other people that are missionaries who are out on the front lines of this world trying to do something for God. But that's why it always amazes me. Some of those people sitting back in the Western world, you know, criticizing about all these little, you know, they're majoring in the minors about little doctrinal disputes of little minor details, you know. That's nonsense. Nonsense with all that's going on in this world. People are perishing every day without Christ. Why are you worried about all that stuff? The only thing you're thinking about is if you'll have the filet mignon. You know, what wine goes with the filet mignon? Maybe that's what people are thinking about sometimes. Some of the people I met, I know that's what they're thinking about, because that's what they talk to me about. You know, the liquor that they drink. Supposed to be Christians talking to me about the liquor they drink with which foods and all this stuff. You know, I'm getting off topic here. These are the kind of things I usually cut off the video. You know, I'm, you know, doing the orphanages and the feeding programs and we built churches and we've had a Bible school, all these other things. I go back to the States and visit multimillionaire people. And instead of, you know, asking me about, you know, well, do you need, you know, we want to build some more orphanages or something, or can you pray for me? As a matter of fact, I didn't go there to even raise money. I went there to pray for people to be filled with the Holy Spirit. I went to pray for people that they get born again and be delivered from whatever their problems are and all that. But instead of talking about them, their own personal condition with the Lord, or even talking about, hey, they want to build an orphanage in the Philippines with their, you know, the blessings that God has given them. Instead, they want to talk to me about which wine they should have with what food and about themselves, on and on and on all day long. And their, you know, their eccentric thinking and lifestyles. Brothers and sisters, this stuff needs to be said. God have mercy on people with such delusions, brothers and sisters. That's why Jesus said, you know, it's easier for the camel to fit through an eye of a needle than a rich man to enter heaven. God bless you guys. I love you guys. You know, you got to say those things. Brothers and sisters, even though 99% of you watching my video, that's, you know, it doesn't apply to you. But brothers and sisters, Jesus said, when you have 100 sheep and one goes astray, won't you leave the 99 and go get the one? And then you rejoice when you got the one. So sometimes, you know, something word that the Lord would give is just for that one sheep. Everybody else is just like, you know, they say amen, or it doesn't apply to them, or are you okay? And that's another example, brothers and sisters, we can't always keep thinking about ourselves, you know. The message is for somebody. Praise God that they would repent. It's like the rich young ruler. The Lord said, you know, give everything you got to the poor and take up your cross and follow me. The young man went away sad because he had lots of possessions. You know, so God deals with us whatever our God is. That's another little nugget of wisdom. Whatever your God is, that's what God deals with. That's why usually you're talking homosexuals. Their God is their sexuality. It's, you know, it's such, if they're telling everybody about it, it's a huge part of their life. Lots of people, they keep their sexual life a secret because it's just a little part of their life, just like money. Some people are rich. They walk down the street. You'd never know they're rich. They just look like a, you know, an average person. The money's not their God. They do give. They help. They do the things. And, you know, they could be a multi-billionaire but or whatever, but it's not their God. It's not the center of their life. That's what I'm trying to say. And the Lord is leading me in the wisdom of way of saying this. Those people that I'm talking about, they're telling me all about their wine and what wines to eat with which food and those kind of things. Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So when they were saying those things, obviously, money was their God because that's what they kept talking about. See what I'm saying? What you speak, Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So like when I'm speaking, I'm always talking about the Lord. Secondarily, the ministry. The ministry stuff that I do for the Lord is secondary to talking about Jesus. I've talked about this before. When I meet with pastors, lots of times, a lot of them, surprisingly, a majority of them will usually talk about the world, worldly stuff, about the Pacquiao boxing match and all this stuff. And that's very painful to hear these comments of those pastors. Then the other group of pastors, the second group, they're always talking about their ministry. Oh, you know, we're trying to grow the church. We need to do this. We need to do that. And that's okay. But very few, I would say less than 10% of the pastors I meet, say, let me tell you about Jesus. Let me tell you what the Lord was showing me in His Word. I'm so excited because God gave me a nugget, you know, of wisdom about who He is, you know, what He is to us or whatever. Like the stuff I'm talking about in this video. Very few want to talk about the Word of God and the wisdom of God and what God showed them and things like that. Brothers and sisters, we all ought to be talking about Jesus all the time. Not worried about the bad news of what's going on in this world, even though it's so popular and gets so many views. Let's talk about these kind of things. That's why I very rarely speak about the worldly events like Jade Helm and all that stuff. Very rarely. A handful of videos I've made. Even though, you know, it's very popular. You get a lot of views for talking about that stuff. But I got to talk about what's in the abundance of my heart. For the Bible says, as I just quoted a minute ago, Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Jesus, the Lord Jesus Christ, and what He's done for me and what He can do for you. Praise God. The Lord loves us, gave Himself for us. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, I'm just thinking about it. I shouldn't even say it that way, what Jesus has done for me and what He can do for you. It's what we can do for Him, you know, kind of like what John Kennedy said, don't ask what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. So let me say it that way. It's not what Jesus can do for me, but He's already done it. But what can I do for Him? Not to earn my salvation, but the result of my salvation. What's the fruit of the Spirit in my life? What's the fruit of my salvation? Not the cause of it. The cause of my salvation is by grace through faith. What He's done for me. But the fruit of my salvation is what I can do for Him. Hallelujah. As He said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. What commandments? That you love your brothers as I have loved you. Brothers in Christ. That the world may know that you are my disciples, Jesus said. The new commandment He gave. That you love one another as I have loved you. Hallelujah. New Testament commandments. Love God with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul, all your body, and love your neighbor as yourself. Do unto others as you'd have them do unto you. Same thing, say in a different words, the golden rule, as they say. Praise God. Praise God. Blessed be His holy name. Brothers and sisters, I love you in the Lord, and I know you all love me, and I appreciate that. Those of you who don't love me, well, you're missing out. Because, you know, it's good to have brothers and sisters in your life who know how to get a hold of God. There's many of you who know how to get a hold of God. If I had a prayer request, there's some of you who I know, you know, I personally know, and I know you can get a hold of God. And I'll contact you. Very few, but there are. There's very few. There's lots of people, you know, I don't know them. I don't know whether they know how to get a hold of God or not. But lots of people cannot get a hold of God. But God wants us all to be able to get a hold of Him. That's what my videos are about, brothers and sisters. That's what my ministry is about, that you would learn how to get a hold of God. Not for me to get a hold of God for you. That's why, you know, I always hesitate about doing the videos of Word of Wisdom, Word of Knowledge, even though my ministry is about that and prophetic and all that. But God wants you to talk to Him, and He wants to talk to you. You know, Jesus is the only mediator between God and man, but it is true. God gives gifts to the church, the gifts of the Spirit. Don't let these old Baptists use that to justify their form of godliness, but denying the power thereof is to use what I just said and said, well, you know, there's one mediator between God and man, and that's the Lord Jesus Christ. We know that that's true about mediating for your forgiveness of your sins and all that thing. We know that. But the Bible also says God gave gifts to the church to edify each other and for the new people to see the power of God and miracles. People that's just not saved yet, they can't operate in the gifts of the Spirit. They can't operate in the supernatural. They need to see it displayed through the church. That's what it's all about. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I've been going on and on. Will I make it one video or two? Well, brothers and sisters, I might make it one because I don't really care about views. I just want to get the information out. So God bless you guys. I love you all. I ask for your prayers as we get ready to travel back to the States. I ask for your prayers for the orphanages, now four, by the grace of God. Hey, the number four, I just thought about it. Hey, the Lord keeps telling me about four. He told me in a dream the other day that the rapture would be in 4 hours. Of course, it wasn't. I knew in my dream that it was symbolic of something. The four blood moons. Now we're going to have four orphanages. How about that? I just realized that. How about that as a sign, a personal road sign? How about that, brothers and sisters? Now, that's cool. That is really cool. Praise God. But then again, maybe we'll have five later on and it won't mean anything. Praise God, brothers and sisters. You know, we can, you know, speculate on these things, but we can't. The problem is there's somebody that will take some stuff like that and run with it. And the rapture's going to be next week. No, you can't do that. You can't do that. That's the problem with all these clowns that are doing that on YouTube, brothers and sisters. We can't do that. We can just do like Mary did when those people were prophesying about Jesus being the Messiah. It says she took those things to heart and considered those things in her heart and kept those things in her heart. So we consider those things and meditate on those things and think about those things and mull them over in our hearts and think about them and pray about them. God bless you guys. Love you guys. This is like one of my old videos I used to do, really long. And I need to do more, and I will. You know, there's a dear sister up in Connecticut. By the grace of God, some of my sermons have been shown on public television all over the state of Connecticut, which Lord knows the Northeast needs it really bad. It's the number one state, I think it's Rhode Island. You know, when I heard that, I thought about Family Guy. Of course, the creator of that is an atheist, and they mock Jesus all the time. The show, would be funny, but there's a lot of really dirty stuff on there. And then, of course, they love to keep blaspheming the Lord, but it's a shame they have to do that, and it's a sign of the times that they can get away with that. You would never see anything like that on TV 20 or 30 years ago or ever before in the history of the United States. But Rhode Island is ranked as the most atheistic state in the United States. And the Northeast, you will see, is rated as the most unchristian or most atheistic part of the United States, brothers and sisters. And they need our prayers like everybody else, you know, more so. You know, just like I had a buddy when I first got in the ministry. He's a matter of fact, he's kind of a famous bluegrass banjo player. And they've even recorded some CDs and stuff. A friend of mine that I used to work with, and then before I went into full-time ministry. And they got a pastor. He's a Baptist church in the middle of nowhere in the mountains of North Carolina. They got a new Baptist preacher who was from, like, New York City. And I was like, we need to send pastors from the mountains of North Carolina to New York City. That New York City pastor needs him up there more than we need him. Even though, of course, people would say the Lord might have sent him here, but in reality, he ended up getting fired because he was having a lot of conflicts with the church. And, I'd go into it, but anyway, they ended up removing him. But, that's aside, it doesn't really matter, but the point is that we need missionaries to go in the northeastern part of the United States and places in certain parts of California and all that. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you all. You know, I've said that about 10 times. You know, like they said, those are preachers in the churches. They'll say, yeah, and before I close, one more thing before I close. But the good thing about this is on demand, you can cut it off, you know, in a church. You're kind of stuck there, you know. You can get up and act like you're going to the bathroom maybe, or start clearing your throat looking at your watch. But this, you can turn it off and watch it later. I know that lots of people don't watch my videos, but they're long because of their long. But I know those of you who do, praise God. I try to get into the meat. You know that I love you guys. I thank the Lord that the Lord would try to, you know, always keep me positive in the ministry. There's so many things to be negative about, and for you guys too, you know, what's going on in the United States and all these things. Of course, we approach the tribulation. Let's stay positive. Let's keep our focus on Christ. Let's keep looking up because God is still on the throne. Ha ha. See, I tied it back in to the beginning of my message. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we give you the praise and the glory, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father, for your grace, your mercy, your love, your loving kindness, your steadfast love. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. My voice is hoarse. I've been talking a long time. Hallelujah. I made another video that I'm not even going to post. It's 30 minutes long. So, hey. Brothers and sisters, God bless you. May the Spirit of the living God overtake you today. May you be baptized in His Holy Spirit. I know I need to make a video about that for prayer. And I've done it way back, and I will do it again as the Lord leads me. And I pray right now and just come in agreement with me. Being baptized in the Holy Spirit is just receiving the Holy Spirit. Just receive. Have, as Paul said, Acts chapter 19, have you received the Holy Spirit since you believe? It's like salvation. Jesus doesn't get back on the throne again. Jesus doesn't get back on the cross again when somebody gets saved. So when you get baptized in the Holy Spirit, God doesn't have another Pentecost. He already gave the Holy Spirit to the church on Pentecost. So you receive it. You receive healing. By His stripes we were healed, it says in 2 Peter 2:24. You were healed. We receive it. We receive salvation. We receive healings. We receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. All things from God we receive by faith. By grace through faith we receive it. Brothers and sisters, so receive. Believe that you receive it. Go read Mark chapter 11, verse 22, 23, and 24. Keep reading it and read it till you get into your spirit. And focus on what it says, what the Lord is saying, and repeat that. Jesus said, have faith in God, for whosoever say to this mountain, say to this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in the heart those things that he saith, when he says them, he shall have whatsoever he saith. So the word saith is repeated many times in there. You got to say it and believe it. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing of the word of God. Say the word of God, by his stripes I am healed, in Jesus' name. I receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name with evidence of speaking in tongues. Receive it in Jesus' name. Receive your salvation, same thing. All who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Romans 10:13, as an example. If we confess with our mouth and believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is Lord and God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Romans 10:9. Praise God. It's all in there, brothers and sisters. Say it and believe it. Confess it and believe it. By faith, by grace through faith. God bless you, brothers and sisters. God bless.